Hello and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Anusha Paul and that's another episode of Daily Roundup. Supreme Court to hear review petition on Sabarimala verdict, opposing about 60 pleas seeking a review of the Supreme Court's verdict on Sabarimala in September 2018 that allowed women from all ages to enter the temple. Kerala government has reiterated its stand and has made it clear that the orders should not be reviewed. 4 months after it allowed women of reproductive age into Sabarimala temple, the court today began hearing the review petition challenging its September verdict. The verdict had set off the massive street protest in Kerala. The annual pilgrimage season saw violent protest as devotees of Ayyappas, the celibate god, tried to stop the women and girls between the ages of 10 and 15 years from entering the shrine. A five-judge constitution bench headed by Chief Justice of India, Rajan Gogoi, is hearing these petitions. However, the Travancore Devasam Court, which had earlier opposed the entry of women of all menstrual ages, has now taken a U-turn, saying that they would respect the Supreme Court verdict. Delhi University Teachers Association marched from Mandi House to Parliament Street on Tuesday and demanded the removal of the university's vice-chancellor over his alleged inaction on some of the important issues. Teaching had come to a complete standstill in the Delhi University, following DUTA's call for strike on Tuesday as thousands of teachers joined the march. The government's delay in promulgating an ordinance bill in the current budget session of the parliament in favour of the 200-point college, university and unit-wise roster has put in danger jobs of a large number of teachers belonging to SC, ST and OBC communities. There have hardly been any permanent appointment in the Delhi University in the last decade. The DUTA demanded that the government brings a one-time ordinance to absorb all the temporary and ad hoc teachers. Ever since its government came into power, it has been constantly trying to privatize higher education and Delhi University with its constituent college through schemes like tripartite MOU and autonomous colleges. The inaction by the Vice Chancellor on important issues has paralyzed the university. The DUTA is demanding removal of the Vice Chancellor for misgovernance. The DUTA demanded that all these issues to be resolved at the earliest by the active intervention of the HRD Ministry. The association also threatened to intensify its agitation in the coming days. The stringent National Security Act, NSA, which is aimed at maintaining the public law and order and national security, has been invoked against the three persons in Madhya Pradesh, Nadeem, Shakil and Azam. On Monday, February 4, they were produced before a local court which sentenced them to jail under the NSA. SB Bahugana claimed that the accused were arrested under the stringent law to maintain the peace in the community-sensitive areas. However, many of the ground have stated that the Congress is following the footsteps of the BJP government by aiming to give a push to the communal agenda in the state for electoral gains. Previously in December, after forming the government, Chief Minister Kamal Nath had announced construction of 1,000 Goshala cowsheds in the next 4 months at the cost of Rs 450 crore and a hike in the allowance for co-fodder to Goshala from Rs 450 paise to Rs 20 per day. The Yogi Adityanath government has imposed an act on all government employees on Monday night, prohibiting them to go on a strike against the government. The act mandates imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 year to any person who instigates a strike, which is illegal under this act. Despite its imposition on the government, workers have decided to launch a strike starting Wednesday against this new pension scheme. The act is oriented towards banning strike in all departments and corporations under it for a period of 6 months. The notification to invoke ISMA was issued by Chief Secretary Anup Chandra Pandey on Monday night. That's all we have for you in today's episode of Daily Roundup. To keep yourself updated, just log on to www.newsclick.in. Also, you can follow us on Facebook and YouTube.